we had the team to go to the podium. Unfortunately, that wasn't necessary for us. But definitely, we controlled what we could, and that was working very hard, doing what we could control, trying to do the processes right, and then hoping for that. I feel like we had a good team that was possibly able to get onto that podium. Okay, so there is a lot of pressure in terms of what is expected of us, also those extra things you need to do before tournament, during tournament, which I'm not using as an excuse. It's been there and it's been taking a bit of energy, but I think it's a normal thing to happen, especially when you're at home in the cup. So, not making any excuses, but there was probably a bit more things that had to be done off court as well. But I think we did well to deal with it all and kind of be thoughtful about our management, not to overload us in terms of that. So, Chris and helping us in that kind of.
To add on what Karen just said, if we had, and I'm saying if, but if we had won New Zealand by one goal, we wouldn't have to be playing Uganda again. And that's a crucial part of coming into such a big tournament. Every match counts. And I know a draw really felt good because New Zealand was quite a great side. But if that one goal, if we got that one, we would play Uganda like we did and win by two, then we'd be in the semi final. And that's what also the bigger teams do. Crunch time, they will stay composed and then win it by one. So they skip certain matches. And you wouldn't then say they would have won against Uganda, for instance, because they wouldn't have played them. So I think there's such a big learning in when we finish today, taking into consideration that there'll be a couple of World Cups coming up, and this can actually help South Africa and other stuff because they can be enough for such things.
On the floor, we've got a lot of complaints on how the draw is all turned.